Just like every other sport, fishing has evolved hugely with the help of technology.
That's right. We're not just talking fancy lures here. You can now use a drone to help you catch the big one.
Well, that is, when it works.
Alistair has the story of the one that really did get away.
Drone fishing has become a bit of a craze for fishing fanatics.
Oh, that's a big fish.
It's a good way to unwind at the end of the week and go out on a Saturday morning and catch some fish.
It's certainly got Matt Banks hooked.
It's a lot easier than surf casting. You probably catch a bit more fish than you do surf casting, and you can get your line out a lot further.
You hook your line with bait attached to the drone and fly it out as far as your line can go.
And you just have to buy the bait and you're away fishing.
The whole point is that a drone can get out to distances that a human cast can't. It does all the work, upping the odds of landing a big one.
This is what it's about. Look at that.
Woo! The reason I got it from Paul's Fishing, there wasn't actually a heck of a lot on the market then, and it was a good price.
Convinced in 2019, Matt got the AEE Condor 500 metre model package, which had a rod, reel, traces on a rack, a hook section, weights, and a rod spike, all for $1,700.
Pretty reasonably priced compared to what else was on the market.
He used the drone happily for a good year until...
And it went perfectly until it crashed. The drone flew up and just went out of control and all over the show. It went about 20 or 30 metres down the beach and then crashed upside down.
Luckily, it landed on the shore, so Matt tried to send it out a second time.
And it went up about 20 metres and it just went out of control again and crashed pretty much in the same spot.
He sent it back to Paul's Fishing. They sent it away to be assessed and discovered the problem was...
Wi-Fi failure.
Which is major, because you lose your Wi-Fi connection and this can happen.
Oh, Joey! Oh my God!
No.
Now, the Banks drone was 5 weeks out of their one-year warranty, but when it comes to major faults like this, the Consumer Guarantees Act can help.
I should have really been either given the option of the drone repair at their cost or a full refund.
He's right, and the shop opted for the repair, but this is where the line gets tangled. Because the store was out of stock of the 500 metre units, they upgraded the drone without talking to the Banks, and then asked them to pay $600 more.
They went ahead and fixed it up with the 1,000 metre unit and expected us to be happy with that, and then expected us to be happy to hand over another $600. For something that's 5 weeks out of warranty that just sort of doesn't wear well with me.
When the Banks disputed the shop's decision, they were put in touch with the store's lawyer, who ultimately told them their insurance should cover the drone repair.
I rang a further 2 times, and I was told I would get a response by the following Monday, and I'm still waiting, and I've had no correspondence from them whatsoever.
That's until Fair Go got involved.
Hi there, it's Alistair Cutter here calling from the TV show Fair Go.
How are you?
We asked Morgan Barnes, owner of Paul's Fishing Systems, for an update on the Banks drone. He was immediately keen to find a solution.
I think we might have some of the old 500 metre drones. If they're happy with the 500 metre, we could probably sort them out with one of those.
We took that to Matt and Janine, but they want a refund. They say their drone's been with the store for 3 months, and in that time they've lost faith in the shop and the drone. So we decided to go to the store, where Representative Caleb Cave was happy to chat.
The outcome we decided to go with was giving them a full refund. They'd advised us that they no longer wanted to use the drone as a fishing style for themselves in the future, so for us it just made sense to give them the full refund of the product.
Caleb says since COVID lockdown, their suppliers have shut down, and so they've had a backlog of requests for stock, which is frustrating for them and for their customers.
It's not a normal thing for us. If anything, we're constantly looking for how we can move to the next best thing, looking at refining the products, making things better.
And as for the lawyer getting involved...
We just wanted to make sure we had the right advice.
It seems it all comes down to poor communication.
Typically, we pride ourselves on being able to look after customers.
Customers like the Banks.
We got a refund. We got a refund for the drone and the battery part of the package that we bought.
So, happy result?
Very.
Yep, very happy.
Oh, nice work.
Yeah.
It's a keeper.
It is. Massive shout out to Paul's Fishing also for fronting up on camera. Do you know that shows that they really care about their customers? Also, takes a lot of guts to be on our show, and that's something a lot of bigger companies often refuse to do.
Yes, it is.